On a night we remember, one of the great college performances we've ever seen. Vince Young, kind enough to really put in the work to be with us tonight. Thanks so much for all your efforts to be on the show. And Vince, that image of you with the confetti falling, I can't tell you how many times I've seen it, and that's the picture in my mind I see of that night. You lived it. What's the image for you of that night you'll always see when you close your eyes?
Oh, man, just a memorable moment, man. Just seeing the fans crying, my teammates crying. I mean, just all the hard work we put in to get to that point. And it wasn't easy. A lot of people make it think that it was easy, but it wasn't. But we put in a lot of hard work, so it was a true blessing to be on that stage and be the quarterback of that football team.
There's one moment, right? There's one play. You either make it or you don't. I mean, that's life in many ways. You have a chance, and you either capitalize or you don't. In your mind, what do you remember most clearly about getting to the end zone to win a title for Texas?
Well, just Rucker chasing me down for one. And Justin Blakemlock making a lane for me. And then all I saw was green grass. So I just took off running, man. I just kind of, when I got across that goal line, all I remember is my whole life flashed in front of me to get to that point, man. It was a great call by Coach Davis and Coach Brown. And we actually talked about that play before we left Austin. Well, you know, if the game was on the line, what play would you call? I actually called quarterback sneak. But coaches being coaches, you know, let's call a pass so you can give you both threats to throw it and run it.
Sure.
And Pete Carrick called that blitz, and all we saw was green, and I just took off from there.
Vince, given how much USC arrived with in terms of hype, and look, we were a big part of that for sure, that had to give you guys a lot of fuel, given that you arrived with 19 straight wins too. How much talk was there in that room about, you know, disrespect is kind of an overplayed card, but just that they were getting all this love and maybe you all weren't? Was that fuel?
Oh, yeah, it was a lot of fuel for us, man. I mean, from USC, you know, going against the Oklahoma teams, I mean, all that stuff, losing the Heisman to Reggie Bush, which he deserved, and the voters did what they did and made a decision. But we was kind of a little fed up with all the talk about USC.
Yeah.
And when we went down there, all we did was stay focused and stay focused on us. And that was a key point that, you know, Coach Brown is a really good coach. He made sure that we not focus on the media. We just focus on what we can do, and that's play the football game.
Vince, tonight, before we were going to have a chance to talk, I read your words that answered the question, what the hell happened to Vince Young? The Players Tribune, your words, you wrote about it. How much was that maybe a relief? I don't want to put the words in your mouth. Writing your story in your own words, what was that process like?
It was a blessing, man. I mean, you know, a lot of times when you talk and do things with the media and things like that, they flip your words a little bit. And Player Tribune was one of those magazines and deals that they kind of, you know, took everything that I said and put it in what I said and my content. And I really did appreciate that. And it actually just did a boost of me getting my book off the ground, as well as a documentary that we're working on as well. So I'm just happy that it came out of my words, because a lot of people don't hear from me. They don't know what happened and what's been said and all these type of things go on, and everybody have their opinions and assumptions and things like that. But I'm just happy that a lot of people heard that and listened to it, and they really got the point that what I was making.
So Vince, on a night where people get a chance to look back at a moment in time that stands for all time, what would you want them to know about where Vince Young is right now? Sitting there talking to me, where's Vince right now?
Vince right now is blessed, man, happy, man, enjoying life, doing real estate, doing transportation and infrastructure. I mean, just staying busy with those type of things, giving back to the community, making sure I'm talking to our younger generation, our younger quarterbacks. I got a lot of relationships with a lot of the quarterbacks that's going into the draft this year. So I'm just kind of like out of the media, but underneath the radar, just doing my thing and just staying blessed and happy with my family. Can go to my son's football games and become a little young coach. So a lot of things that's going on in my life, man. I'm very happy and blessed. And then I'm happy to see that this game is on TV, that we can relive it, because it goes down in history. So, I mean, I was texting Matt Lino a while ago, and he's like, man, I hate you right now.
Well, you've used a great word a lot as we've talked here, and that's blessed. And I think that's what we all hope to be. And you sound like you feel sincerely blessed, and I hope you stay that way, man. And I appreciate you taking the time to be with us. Stay safe, all the people you care about. I hope they're well. I hope they're safe. Lay low until this thing passes, and we look forward to crossing paths somewhere down the road. All right, Vince?
No problem, man. I appreciate it. And everybody out there in the world, man, you guys stay blessed, stay safe, stay at home, pay attention. Look at this as a learning experience for everybody, man, and get back to work when it's time to go back.
Thank you, Vince.
No problem. Thanks, guys.